Good morning. We are live here at People's United Methodist Church in South Thomaston and on John Street United Methodist Church page also. And this is our fifth Sunday of the month. We're going to be doing readings and hymns, favorite hymns. You'll see some old friends here that you haven't seen for a little while. But first, we're going to sing Part of the Family. So here we go. Let me just get that in the right place. And join with me, please. Strong 85ers and streetwise 16s, we are a part of the family. Greeters and shoppers, long time and new, nobody here has a claim on a pew. So whether we're many or whether we're few, we are a part of the family. Come in and sit down, you are a part. We are a part of the family. Come in and sit down. You are a part of the family. We are lost and we are found, and we are a part of the family. Okay, so we're going to have most of this is going to be on the PowerPoint when we get to it. And right now I'd like to have you join me in the call to worship, if you can see it. All right, so everybody's going to say, praise the Lord in his sanctuary and his mighty heavens. Praise the Lord for his acts of power and surpassing greatness. Praise the Lord with sounding trumpet, with harp and lyre. Praise the Lord with timbrel and dancing strings and pipes. Praise the Lord with clashing, resounding cymbals, and let everything that has breath praise the Lord. This is one of Priscilla's favorite songs that she told us about. And you, if you have your hymnal, you could turn to page 344. For Lord, you have come to the lake shore, verses 1 and 2. Smiling
change.
Okay, thank you, Priscilla, for suggesting that particular piece. It's one of our favorites, especially down here on the water. And now, I believe we have Priscilla reading one of her favorite pieces. Oh, no, it's Georgia, sorry.
They will receive what God has promised. Happy are those whose greatest desire is to do what God requires. God will satisfy them fully. Happy are those who show mercy to others. God will show mercy to them. Happy are the pure in heart. They will see God. Happy are those who work for peace among men. God will call them his sons. Happy are those who suffer persecution because they do what God requires. The kingdom of heaven belongs to them. Happy are you when men insult you and mistreat you and tell all kinds of evil lies against you because you are my followers. Rejoice and be glad because a great reward is kept for you in heaven. This is how men mistreated the prophets who lived before you.
And now, if you have your hymnals, we're going to sing verses 1 and 4 of It Is Well With My Soul, and that is on page number 377. I always remember this one because we sang it at Mom's funeral, and it was always one of her favorites also.
Thank you.
words of Jesus recorded in Matthew 11, 28 through 30. Come to me, all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
On a music note, I always love it when the Bible quotes Handel from the Messiah, not the other way around. And now I have been asked to do the song Standing on the Promises a la Alberta Kimball. I don't know that I'm going to be able to live up to her name, but I will give it a try. So Standing on the Promises, hymn number 374, verses 1 and 2.
Let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, for he made it. In his hands form the dry land. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care.
And the next hymn is the Hymn of Promise. That's on page 707 in your hymnal. And I'm not sure how many verses are up there. It's a short hymn. It's only got three verses anyway, so we'll just do the whole thing.
Season, something God alone can see.
A reading from Romans chapter 12, verses 9 through 21. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful what you do, to do what is right in the eyes of everyone. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath, for it is written, "It is mine to avenge, I will repay," says the Lord. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. The next reading is from Matthew, chapter 16, verses 21 through 28, the New International Version. From that time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things at the hands of the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law, and that he must be killed and on the third day be raised to life. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. "Never, Lord," he said. "This shall never happen to you." Jesus turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me. You do not have in mind the concerns of God, but merely human concerns." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will find it. What good will it be for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit their soul? Or what can anyone give in exchange for their soul? For the Son of Man is going to come in his Father's glory with his angels, and then he will reward each person according to what they have done. Truly I tell you, some who are standing here will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom.
Your protector is always with you. Protector Israel never dozes or sleeps. The Lord will guide you. He will be by your side to protect you. The sun will not hurt you in the day, nor the moon in the night. The Lord will protect you from all danger. He will keep you safe. He will protect you as you come and go now and forever.
Our next hymn
is number 397, verses 1 and 4. I need thee every hour. And now we'll hear from our friends, Pat and Ralph.
Until I was older, and then someone pointed out to me that only on one side of the door was the knob, and it was on the side that, not on Jesus' side, but on the person's side. So I discovered that again, that the person had to open the door. search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if a child asks for bread, will give a stone? Or if a child asks for fish, will give a snake? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good things to those who ask you? And I'm reading one of Ralph's favorite verses, which is in Corinthians 13, the gift of love. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body, so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecy, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three.
Ralph wanted me to mention that he used to read that passage a lot, especially at weddings, but also sometimes at funerals. And they also wanted me to let people know that the day that I taped them, I'm not sure if it was Thursday or Friday, I can't remember. It was their 65th wedding anniversary. So that's quite a milestone. And the person who spoke a couple before Ralph and Pat was Bob Smith. And Bob and Joy Smith were married by Ralph Miller. So it's a whole circle. All right, so Ralph wanted to sing this one. He said, when you get up to be 86 years old, you think about this a lot. It's not in your hymnal. I had to find it somewhere else, but I have the words up here. I hope you can see them, and I'm going to do the best I can.
Thank you.
Okay, now is the time for, now is the time for making sure that we have the pledges and offerings come in. And I just got a message to say the microphone's not picking up on the computer, and I'm sorry about that. You can look up those readings yourself and read them to yourself. It was good to see our friends' faces, right? And so this is a time for prayers and concerns. And the only prayer I got this week was from Priscilla, that she has a friend, Joanne, a faithful viewer from Waterville, has multiple health concerns. And so we thank Priscilla for making sure that we know about that. I think we all have prayers and concerns about the state that things are going in our country with so much unrest and so much violence. And if we can do our best to alleviate that, you know, each and every person, then hopefully things can get better. I would like to have us all, if we could, say the Lord's Prayer to, no, not the Lord's Prayer, the Psalm 23 together as part of our prayer, and then go right into the Lord's Prayer. So if you will all join me with the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So just for a moment, I wanted to read one of the passages that I liked quite well, that I responded to, especially as a kid. It's Psalm 98. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He's remembered his love and his faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the peoples with equity. Now, I wasn't sure which psalm this was, so what I did was I Googled, make a joyful noise to the Lord. And because that's what I have been doing since I was an infant, I'm sure. I'm not sure it was always joyful, but I'm not sure my parents would say that all the noises that I made were joyful noises. But I did make a lot of noise. So there you have it. I remember my very first real job. I was 14 years old and I babysat 40 hours a week for an infant who wasn't going to turn one until September. And there was noise. And I remember one day I had taken the little baby out for a walk in the stroller. And when I came back to the house, I did not know that the mother had returned because she had a severe headache and she was upstairs asleep or attempting to sleep. And I came in the house and I was singing to the baby, the popular songs of the day. So it was Three Dog Night, the one about the circus. Oh, I must let the show go on. And I am singing that at the top of my lungs and the baby's laughing. And the mother came down over the stairs and dismissed me for the day. So my joyful noise was not her joyful noise, but hey, when you're making 75 cents an hour, you kind of have to do what the boss says. So make sure that your noise is joyful, but keep in mind other people too. Make sure that it's joyful for everyone. So there were a couple of other suggestions for verses, and I was going to read those also. I wasn't sure how long this was going to be, so I didn't really have too much else for the music. But here's one that a friend had suggested. It's from Jeremiah 29, verse 11. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." And another one that Bessie sent in from Ephesians 3,20. "Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly beyond all that we ask or think, according to the power that works within us." So thank you for being with us, and I'm really sorry that things haven't been as loud as they need to be. I'm really not sure how to make that work without getting microphone feedback. So here's our last... Oh, wait a minute, we have to do the sending forth. Here we go, the sending forth. Everybody, here it is. And together, please.
New every morning is your love, great God of light. And all day long you are working for good in the world. Stir up in us desire to serve you, to live peacefully with our neighbors and all your creation, and to devote each day to your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And how many of you have memorized this? Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. Thank you for joining us, and I hope it wasn't too awful without the sound. And if you want to look this one up, it's really, really wonderful. It's an a cappella version of Lift Every Voice and Sing. Thank you.
Rejoicing, rise, guide us
Have a wonderful week.